We want to determine the derivative of the given function using the limit definition of the derivative, and then determine f prime of 3, which will tell us the slope of the tangent line at x equals 3 on the function. So here's the limit definition of the derivative. So f prime of x, or the derivative of f, is going to be equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of this difference quotient. Notice our numerator is f of x plus h minus f of x. So for f of x plus h, we're going to replace x with x plus h. So we'll have the square root of x plus h plus 1 minus f of x, which is just the square root of x plus 1, all over h. So f of x plus h is equal to the square root of x plus h plus 1, and f of x is equal to the square root of x plus 1. Now looking at this difference quotient, we want to manipulate this so that we can determine this limit by direct substitution. Notice if we attempt direct substitution now, we have division by 0, which is undefined. So what we're going to do is multiply. So what we'll do here is multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the numerator. So we're going to multiply by the square root of x plus h plus 1 plus the square root of x plus 1. Our denominator is going to be the same. Now let's see what this gives us. We're going to leave the denominator in factored form, so we'll have h times square root of x plus h plus 1 plus square root of x plus 1. And now we multiply the numerator. Because they're conjugates, this is going to simplify nicely. Notice for this first product, we're multiplying two square roots with the same radicand, so the result will just be the radicand of x plus h plus 1. Now the next two products will be opposites. Here we have a positive product of the same two square roots, so that'll be 0. And then we're going to have minus the product of the square root of x plus 1 times the square root of x plus 1, which is just x plus 1. But we are subtracting the quantity x plus 1. Now let's go ahead and clear these parentheses and see what simplifies. There should be a closed parenthesis here as well. So we have x plus h plus 1, and then minus x minus 1, all over the same denominator. And now we almost have it here. Notice that we have x minus x, that's 0, and we have 1 minus 1, that's 0. So let's go ahead and write this one more time. Our numerator is just h, and we have a factor of h in the denominator, so that's going to simplify out. So again, we have a common factor of h here, that's equal to 1, and now as h approaches 0, our denominator is going to approach the square root of x plus 1 plus the square root of x plus 1, which is equal to 2 square roots of x plus 1. So our numerator is 1, and our denominator is 2 square root of x plus 1. And this is the derivative of our given function. So now that we have the derivative, we can determine the value of the derivative at x equals 3. Let's go ahead and do that on the next page. So if we replace x with 3 in the derivative, we'll have 1 over 2 times the square root of 3 plus 1, that's going to be 4. So we have 1 over 2 times 2, which is equal to 1/4. So this tells us the slope of the tangent line to our function is 1/4 at x equals 3. Remember, our function was f of x equals the square root of x plus 1. So if we wanted to know the point of tangency, or the point where the slope of the tangent line is equal to 3, we'd have to evaluate the function at x equals 3. So it doesn't ask us in the question, but the point of tangency would be 3, 2. And let's go ahead and verify this graphically. Here's our function f of x. So in red, we have the graph of our function, which is f of x equals the square root of x plus 1. Notice how our point of tangency is the point 3, 2. And from the derivative, we determine that the slope of this tangent line is equal to 1/4. And that's going to do it for this example. I hope you found this helpful.